is awkward. I know I've been gone for a while. I know, you don't have to tell me. I'm well aware. I haven't been posting, obviously, because school, well, obviously it's summer now, so what's my excuse? School really had me effed up, so I was really stressed with that, doing classwork, sleeping, like, I was working, like, sometimes I just get into like this funk where I don't know what to do. I don't want to make any videos because I know they're not going to be good. Like, I like my shits to be perfect, as you guys know. I didn't feel motivated, basically, is what I'm trying to say. And I was busy with school, but now it's summertime, so I'm going to be banging out these videos and it's going to be lit. So this video was me showing y'all how I do my edges. A lot of you guys have been asking me. So yeah, if you guys want to see how I slay these mother effing edges, keep on watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And yeah, let's get on with this video. So I just washed my hair and I just did some quick braids because I didn't want to be dealing with it. I'm just gonna start off by saying, don't cut your hair. Don't try to make baby hair. Don't do that. Don't freaking do that. So first things first, I'm gonna let you guys know what you guys need. You guys are going to need three things. The first thing is obviously the gel, super important. I use the Eco Styler olive oil gel. She's bomb, she's great, she won't let you down. Right, so the next thing that's super duper important is the toothbrush. I use this regular Schmegler toothbrush. It's a Colgate one. It doesn't really matter the brand. So I like using a toothbrush like this that's flat instead of one like this, like that's kind of curvy, because I feel like it's just easier to like grasp onto the hair or whatever. So the last thing you're gonna need is a satin scarf. Yeah, this is also very important because after you do your edges, you need to set them, you know, like when you do your makeup, you gotta set it so it stays. So you need a scarf to set your edges. I feel like a lot of people don't do that and it's really important. That's why your edges look good when you get out the door, but when you come back, you look busted. So the first thing I do is I set them all out. Like I make sure they're all out. And when before I braided, I made sure that I didn't like braid too tight so I couldn't take my hairs out. So I take about like that much and then I take it off and I put it on my finger just so you don't put in too much. And I like to start on this side. I like to make my edges like kind of like steps. And my mom always says that I'm making a staircase on the side of my head. Lay it flat, and then when I curve it, I put my finger on it and then I just swerve it to the back. Here. I'm always gonna go back and fix this one, my problematic one, and then I'm gonna just keep doing that, you know, flatten it, swerve it to the back, and then I keep taking from this finger that I have the gel, you know, and then I use another finger to flatten it. Like, I'm not using the one with the gel. So see, you got that. Now for this one, sometimes I just swoop this all the way back, or I go like this, and then I leave this little one right here. Okay, so that's one side done. Now I'm gonna go to this side. So as you guys can see, this is the before and this is the after. Like look at the difference. Like, bitch, I look like a hot mess on this side, and on this side I look like I take care of myself. Like, she brushes her hair, look at her, you know. I'm just gonna I dip back in, and I don't take a lot of gel because, girl, you don't want that shit to get clumpy. So I'm gonna go right here to my center one, and I like to make sure that it's all like flat out before I swoop it in. Just go like that, and then I swoop it. And I like it when the edge is like fully like covered. Like, I don't, you see this one? You see how it looks like there's like no hair right there? I hate that. So I like to make it seem like, well, not make it seem, but like I like to brush out all the hairs because I hate when there's gaps. So then I'm just gonna brush the rest of it back into my braid so it can like flow. So now what I like to do is I like to take some of this one and swoop it the other way. It's just like a signature thing of mine. Like, I like making my edges go different directions. Just this one. I always make this one go a different direction. That's just like my thing, you know. I just let her swoop that way. She could be different, live her life. So now I'm just gonna take the other side of that edge and just do the same thing but the other way. And since I did braid my hair, it is kind of harder to grab the hair because some of it is still in my braid. So I just like to, sorry if you guys can't see, but yeah. This is like so hard to explain. You're more like, you have to really like play with it yourself because everybody has different hairlines and like, you know, different amount of baby hairs. But yeah, like you just have to practice, and it's not even, it's like not hard at all. You just gotta, I feel like I'm not really good at explaining, but like just watch, you know. So like I said, again, flatten the hairs, gonna swoop it. The rest of the back, see that? It's bothering me, so I gotta fix it. There you go. Alright, so there they are all laid out. So now, what the last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my scarf and I'm gonna fold it like a bandana, kind of, because I have braids in, so I don't have to. I mean, you can like do it like this, like all the way, but since I have braids on, I'm just gonna fold it like this. I'm gonna show you guys, hold on, hold it like this. And now I'm just gonna be careful. Wait, actually, hold on, because you see how, remember I told you guys that this one lifts up a lot? So I'm just gonna take gel on my finger, just a little tiny bit, and flatten it one more time before I put the scarf on it, so it could lay even flat, like the way I really want it to be. And I'm just gonna put my finger on her so she don't try to get up. There she is. And now I'm just gonna carefully go on there. I'm gonna tie this really tight because you want them shits to dry to your skin and make it look like a tattoo. I don't know. Yeah, so you want to make sure you press on it so like your edges like stick to your freaking face. I like to leave it until I feel like the gel has dried. So like I'll do this before I do my makeup. So I'll do my hair first. I'll lay my edges and then I'll start doing my makeup. So I'll do my eyebrows, I'll do my eyes, but then when I start to like put foundation on, I'll take it off, and by that time it'll be dry. I'm gonna wait a couple minutes, and when they're dry, I'll be right back to show you guys. Okay, so it's been about a couple minutes now, and I'm just gonna take my scarf off. You want to be careful the way you're taking it off, especially since I made one of my like baby hairs go a different way, or like, you know, you want to take it off super gently because it might ruin it. Literally after this, everything is like cemented on. These witches aren't going anywhere. So this is what my edges look like after I take my scarf off. Like I'm telling you guys, this step is super like crucial, especially in the summer, because this heat does not want your edges to be great. So I know you guys can relate. Like look at this little curl, and then look at this big ass piece of hair. Like who told you? I'm gonna have to put that back because she's doing too much. How I lay my edges, and yeah, you guys have been asking me, so I'm motherfucking did it, and there you go. Super simple, super quick, literally takes me like 5 minutes to do. The only thing that really takes us time is setting it, because if you take the scarf off before it's dry, it's literally not gonna stay. It's just, they're just gonna melt right off, especially in this heat, girl. But yeah, that's how I lay my edges. Alright guys, so that is the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love and appreciate you guys so much. And yeah, see you in the next one.